गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी ऑफ क्लास 10 साइंस। एंड टुडे टॉपिक वी विल कवर द पावर एंड द कमर्शियल यूनिट ऑफ एनर्जी एंड व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी। पावर विच द टॉपिक कवर्ड इन 9th क्लास एंड यू नो वेरी वेल व्हाट इज पावर मींस हाउ मच टाइम a person take to do work, or the person who do work very fast, that we can say that he has more power. It means power is depend upon the work in a given interval of time is completed, means how much work you have completed in a given interval of time. Or we can say in simple definition, the rate of doing work is known as power. Means rate of doing work, here is it means power is equal to rate of doing work, here is work upon my time, it represents the rate of doing work, and power is equal to work upon my time, and this work is represent the energy which we have done in 9th class. And in 9th class what you have done also, and the unit of power is 1 watt, which is equal to 1 work, means this is energy upon my time taken, and the unit of energy is joule and time unit is second. It means you also know what is the unit of power, that is watt. And in 9th class the unit of power how you define, when 1 joule of work done in 1 second, this is equal to 1 watt. It means power of 1 watt means how much work, mean only 1 joule you have complete in how much time, means only 1 second. If 1 joule of work is complete or done in 1 second, that is known as watt, 1 watt, which you have done in previous 9th class. But here we will use another topic. Topic is electric power. Electric power means rate at which the energy is dissipated. Dissipated is already explained you, means spent, means waste, or it may be consumed. Either we have may be consumed the energy or the waste. It depends on us. But sometime yesterday or the previous classes which you have completed, that the energy when passing, when energy is, most of the energy is get dissipated in form of heat, which is useless. But in electrical appliances in which the heating effect is produced, that heat we can utilize. So simply we will define the electric power, the rate of electric energy is dissipated or consumed in an electric current. It means when we pass the current, at what rate the energy is consumed. It means here electric energy depend upon the amount of current. Current is passed, it means when the current will pass, when the electron will be in motion, when the under what condition the electron will be in motion, when there will be a create or difference of potential, means across the potential difference, and it is created only attachment with the battery or the cell, which help to create the potential difference, and this creation of potential difference help to move the electron which produce the electric current. And here is electric power is the rate at which the electrical energy is consumed or dissipated in an electric current. And now SI unit of power is what? SI unit of power same is watt. And now before explaining the watt and what is power in electric power, we know which your definition, power is equal to energy upon my time. It means we, when we cross multiply, it means energy is equal to power into time. You have to note it down, this proof from here. It means E is equal to P into T, and E is generally represented the energy which is equal to heat, and heat H, we know H is equal to what? First formula is I square RT, second formula is V into Q, VIT, third is V square upon me R into T and V into Q. This formula you have done in previous class, the heat which is equal to I square RT, VIT, V square upon me R into T and VQ. So it means what is energy? Energy, what we find out? Power. So that means power is equal to E upon me T. E upon me T means H upon me T. It means first case, E, P is equal to, what is H? I square RT upon me T, it will cut. So it means I square R. This is the first formula of power. And the second formula, power is equal to H upon T, whereas H is equal to VIT, P is equal to VIT, this is H upon my T, T means T, T will cut, V is equal to VI, it means this is the second formula of power. And the third formula is P is equal to H upon T, what is H? P, H, V square T upon my R into my T, and this T will cut, so power is equal to V square upon me R. And the last one is P, E is equal to V into Q. So that means power is equal to energy, heat upon me time, V into Q upon me time, this Q upon me time is equal to V into I. This is the same formula, is this V into I. So at last we got the result, P is equal to I square R and V into I and V square upon my R. This is the formula of power, but generally we are defining this way, power. VI is the formula of power, I square R is the formula of power, V square upon my R is the formula of power. Then electric power, in unit of electric power, what? On the basis of this formula, how we can define what? What is the unit of power which is equal to, listen carefully, this power, unit of power is 1 watt is equal to potential difference when 1 watt into 1 ampere. It means 1 watt, how we can define 1 watt? 1 watt is the unit of power or the power consumed by an electrical device. By an electrical device, electrical appliances that carry, it means that electrical appliances carry the current of 1 ampere across the potential difference of 1 volt. If 1 ampere of current pass through an electrical appliances having the potential difference or the power of or the potential difference of 1 volt, then the power will be 1 watt. 1 watt, it is the power consumed by an electrical device that carry a current of 1 ampere. It means when 1 ampere of current is flow through a circuit or through that electrical appliances and across the potential difference of 1 volt, it means when the potential difference will be 1 volt, yeah, it will operate it at a potential difference of 1 volt, then the power will be 1 watt. And 1 watt is the smallest unit of power, and higher unit is kilowatt, which is equal to 1000 watt, or we can also use also higher unit MW. 1 megawatt means 10 power 6 watt, and which is equal to 1000 kilowatt means 1 megawatt is the higher unit than kilowatt, and kilowatt is the higher unit than watt. It means smallest unit of power is watt, and 1 kilowatt is the higher unit which is equal to 1000 watt, and megawatt is the higher unit than the kilowatt which is equal to 10 power 6 watt. And now electrical energy, we know the formula, energy is equal to power into time. Same electrical energy is also equal to energy is equal to power into time. Power into time. Then if the electrical energy or the energy is equal to power into time, in case of electrical energy, electrical energy is equal to power into time. It means what is the unit of power? What is the unit of time is R. It means unit of electrical energy. Unit of electrical energy is what? R. What R? Unit of electrical energy is what? R. And what is the definition of 1 watt R? If one will say, define the unit of electrical energy, then 1 watt R means 1 watt, mean 1 watt into my 1 R. How we can define 1 watt R? We know very well, 1 watt R is the unit of electrical energy. And definition of 1 watt R, when an electrical appliances of 1 kilo 1 watt of 1 of 1 watt of 1 watt used in use for 1 hour, it is known as 1 watt hour. 1 watt hour is the unit of electrical energy. Why? Because electrical energy is equal to power into time. Unit of power is watt and unit of time is hour. Therefore, unit of electrical energy is what? R. And definition of 1 watt R is when an electrical appliances, means electrical appliances of power. What is the power of that electrical appliances? 1 watt. When an electrical appliances of 1 watt operated for 1 hour. Yeah, when an electrical appliances of 1 watt used for 1 hour. That is the 1 watt R. But the commercial unit of energy is 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of energy. It means the unit, the energy which we consumed in our house, and the energy consumption bill which we get after the month. How much energy we consumed with 10 unit, 20 unit, 30 unit. This unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. It means 1 kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of energy. We generally used 1 unit. 1 unit means 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour means 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt into my 1 hour. It means commercial unit of energy is 1 kilowatt hour. Mean 1 unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into my hour. What do you understand by 1 kilowatt hour? Means when an electrical appliances of 1 kilowatt, when an electrical appliances of 1 kilowatt, when an electrical appliances of 1 kilowatt used for 1 hour means electrical appliances of power 1 kilowatt when used for 1 hour, then this energy is used or consumed is known as 1 kilowatt hour, which is equal to 1000 watt hour. And how many joule? It means 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joule. This is the commercial unit of energy and this is the SI unit of energy. And what is the relationship between the commercial unit of energy and SI unit of energy, which is equal to 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joule. Joule is SI unit of energy. And how this relation we can derive? 1 kilowatt being 1000 watt into my 3600 second. We know 1 hour is equal to 3600 second. This we know very well. And 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. And then 1, 2 multiplied 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. इट मीन 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 इंटू में 36 वॉट एंड सेकेंड, इट मीन 36 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड दिस विल बी वॉट. वॉट इज वी यू हैव डन P is equal to in SI unit work done upon my time and power is equal to 1 watt is equal to 1 joule upon my 1 second. This is joule which is the SI unit of energy. It means 1 watt is equal to 1 joule upon my 1 second. 1 joule upon my 1 second into my second. This second that will cut and then 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour, 1 kilowatt hour is equal to, and now put decimal. When we move from right to left, we have to increase the power of 10. 1, 2, 3, decimal is here. Need not write decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It means standard form is 3.6 into 10 power. Point, if I am putting place, point it here. Here I am putting decimal, so it means count the number of digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this is 6 joule. In this way, this is the relationship between the commercial unit of energy and SI unit of energy. And this relationship very important and the question based on the commercial unit of energy is very important and the numerical from this chapter is generally asked in the board examination and please prepare for that. And we will start the textbook question and in class, in one class, if any, how many the question will solve and remaining you have to do yourself and please be careful for that. And now question number first, a piece of wire exercise. This is the exercise of chapter electricity. Question number first. A piece of wire has the resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts. A wire which has length of AB and the resistance of this wire is R, it cut into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It means when the wire of resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts, then the resistance will decrease, increase or same. We know very well resistance is directly proportional to the length of a wire. If the total length of wire is AB whose resistance is R, then it cut into 5 equal parts, then the resistance of each wire will be R1, this is R1 equal to, this is R2, this is R3, R2, R3, R4 and R5. And what is the resistance? Can you tell me? If a wire of length L, of any length, but having the resistance R is cut into 5 equal length, then what will be the resistance of each wire? What is the resistance of each wire? They are in equal part, which obtained from this wire of resistance R. Can you tell me? Each resistance will be same. R upon 5, R upon 5, R upon 5, R upon 5. If this wire is cut into 6 part, then this will be R upon 6. If this wire is cut into 3 equal part, then the resistance of each wire will be R upon 3. Here is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. And after what the question is saying? And then are connected in parallel, means they are connected in parallel. This one, 1. And now simple diagram I am drawing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And they are connected in parallel. This is R1, R2, R3, R4 or R5. You know, when they are connected in parallel, what is the effective resistance? R is the effective resistance. And how we can calculate? In parallel, 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. And this will be 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon or this R1, R upon 5, 5 will goes into upward, means 5 upon R plus R2, this will be same, 5 upon R, and this will be also 5 upon R, this will be also 5 upon R, this will be also 5 upon R, and add with, that will be 5 is common, and that will be 1 upon R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon R, and it will be 1 upon R is equal to 5, and when we add, it will make us form answer, this will be 5 upon R, 5 into 5, 25, 25, this is, we will put the name is P, RT, and then RP, 1 upon RP is equal to 25 upon R, then RP is equal to R upon 25. And now what the question is saying, R upon my R dash, R upon R, it is double dash, achha, here is double dash, the question is R double dash, and now put the value of R, here is R, and R dash is R upon 25, and 25 will be numerator, this R will cut, R upon R dash is equal to 25 upon 1, with then what is your option is D part. And now move to question number second. Second you do yourself, this is the formula. Question number third, question electric bulb rated 220 volt, it means the potential difference is 220 volt and 100 watt, power is 100 watt and potential difference is 220, when it is operated at 110, means an electric bulb, this, but next time I will not make any diagram, it is operated at 220 volt, and then this is power is equal to 100 watt. If the power of this bulb will be, if the voltage is changed from 120 to 110, then what will be the power consumed? Can you answer? We know, this first P1 is equal to 100 watt and V1 is equal to 220 watt volt, and P2 is equal to question mark, and V2 is equal to 110 volt. We know power is equal to P is equal to power, power is equal to potential difference into my current. It means P is equal to V into I. It means P1 is equal to V1 I1. And I is same, and then P2, this is equation first, and then P2 is equal to, what is P2? Is V2 and this is I. But this V, I am, it is not, it is same or not? It means power and potential difference V1 and I1, but we don't know, the resistance of the wire is same. Here is 100, it means when we put, change the potential difference, then automatically this depend is directly on potential difference, or we can I, what is I? V1 is equal to V upon me R, this is V1, it means V1 square upon me R. Why we are using R? Yeah, because the resistance of this bulb is same, 100 watt. If you will change the voltage, then the resistance will change or not, power, this power is directly depend upon the potential difference, square of the potential difference. And same, V2 is equal to V2 upon me, I is equal to V, this will be V square upon me, V2 upon me, R. And now, what we do now? this P1, this is first equation and this is second equation. And now what should I do? P1 upon divide first and second. Divide first by second. What is P1 upon me P2? What is P1? V1 square upon me R into me divided. This will be V2 square upon me R. P1 upon me P2. V1 square upon me R into reciprocal R upon me V2 square. This R will cut and now put the value of P1 and P2. It means P1 upon P2 is equal to V1 upon V2 whole square. And now what is your answer? P1. What is P1? 100. Upon me. What is P2? We have to find out. Is equal to. What is V1? V1 is 220 upon me. This will be 110 whole square. And 0. This will be 1 and 2. It means 100 upon me P2 is equal to 2 whole square. 2 square is 4. So that means 100 upon me P2 is equal to 4. Cross multiply 4 P2 is equal to 100 and P2 is equal to 100 upon 4 is equal to 25. So it means power is equal to 25 watt. It means when we change the potential difference, then automatically power will change. Conjunction of power will be changed. First, what we have done? P1 is equal to this, V1, P2, V2, P is equal to VI. We have changed this because the resistance of this bulb and we apply, we don't know the amount of current, then we change V1 square because power is directly, we have to depend upon power is potential difference. Resistance, we are assuming the same, which is a constant. So therefore, V1 is equal to V1 according to Ohm's law. This R is constant. Then V2 is equal to, this will be P1. We have to put I. I is equal to V upon R from here. This one. I is equal to V upon, V is equal to IR. And then it is according to Ohm's law. I, V upon I is equal to R. But we have to find out I, I is equal to this. I is equal to V upon R. We put the value of I. V upon R. V1 upon R. Resistance is constant. And this is P1 is equal to V1 square upon R. P2 is equal to V2 square upon R. Then P1 divided by P2. We apply the formula and at last we put the numerical value. And then note it down and please be careful.